Despite the lies that you're making, your love is mine for the taking. My love is just waiting to turn your tears to roses. Run to my love is a burden, consuming fire.
inside. We are skillet. It's gonna be a good new year. Everybody here has something that you are sick of. Maybe it's loneliness, abuse, addiction. I'm gonna dedicate this song to some brand new friends I met tonight from Teen Challenge who have gotten their lives straight, gotten off of drugs. I love it because the Bible says that Jesus came to set you free. Raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it, raise your. Raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it. Raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it. Raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it. It's so great to be here. I see a lot of people I've seen before. I love you, returning people. Gonna be the best New Year's ever. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Let me hear you say, oh, oh. Go, 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 here we go, go. Yeah. Somebody say, woo! Everybody having a good time tonight? Man, it's good to be here. We are Skillet. How many people have never seen Skillet play before? Never. We judge you. I'm not even joking. I'm just kidding. All you first time people, we love you. I love seeing brand new faces out here. Thank you so much for coming. I hope it's a great night for you. You having fun so far? Maybe you're like this person who's seen us over 20 times. It's good to see you again. Or over here. I think this might be the record. Where are they? I saw them. Oh, yeah. 112. That's a lot of Skillet concerts. It's actually too many. But it's great to be here. We're gonna play a song for you. Some of you guys are gonna know. If you don't know it, I think it's a cool song for going into 2019. How many people would rather stand up and be strong in 2019? Then bow down to compromise, bow down to weakness. Here's the awesome thing about our God, is that when we are weak, He shows Himself strong. That's what the Bible says. So I'll say it again, because maybe everybody doesn't know that's what the Bible says. When we are weak, He shows Himself strong. So when we go into 2019, it's okay to be weak, but you gotta ask Jesus to help you. Because I want to go into 2019 with all of my weaknesses. I want to go into 2019 saying, Jesus, I know that I'm weak, but in my weakness, You are going to show Yourself strong, because the Bible says so. And this could be a year. I'm not just saying this because it's Jesus talk. I mean it. This could be a year for some of you people that you finally quit that addiction. This could be the year for some of us here that we finally forgive someone who's not only hurt you, but does not deserve your forgiveness. How many people know that that's exactly who we are? None of us deserve forgiveness. Somebody say amen. I'll just keep preaching all night. Maybe 2019 is a year for some of you to say, God, I don't want to forgive this person. I don't think they deserve it. But neither did I. And maybe God will show Himself strong in your life as you daily begin to forgive someone who's hurt you. I don't know what your story is, but this song we're going to play for you, I think, is a cool theme song for 2019. It is about being brave, and it is about standing up strong in Jesus. Sing it with me if you know it, please. Today we live, today we breathe, today we know that we are strong when we are weak. Today we trust, we overcome, take every chain that kept us slaves and throw them off. We're not waiting for permission, we defy our inhibition, like our middle name is fearless. If we're gonna follow the fire ideals, arms count wide. If we're gonna feel we fairly wrong, we will rise. The title power we will know, by the spirit we own. If we're gonna stand, we stand and shine. If we're gonna walk, Song. I think it's okay if we all lose our voices going into the new year, right? It's a holiday, you don't need your voice tomorrow. Oh man. First, if you don't know the song, I'm gonna teach it to you. It's easy. First, you gotta go like this. Oh yeah, I know you can clap now. I'd love to see those hands. Let me see them. Oh yeah, now as loud as you can, say yeah! Say yeah! Say woo! Yeah! Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-back! 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 Say! Oh yeah! Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-back! No, no! Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-back! What is that? She made me feel like I am back from the dead!
Just to say I love you.
try to pull me into the dark. I struggle to find my way as I'm slipping from your arms.
It's getting harder to stay awake, and my strength is fading fast. You breathe into me at last.
I'm alive, I'm alive. Now I know what I painted inside.
I know it's my time.
I'll do what I want, cause this is my life.
You're right here,
right now.
I'll stand my ground and never back down.
I know what I believe inside. I'm awake and I'm alive. Thank you so much.
We'll be right back.
Yeah. How's everybody feeling up in here tonight? We got some rock and rollers here. I met people tonight who came all the way from Mexico over here. I think that's the farthest. There's some rockers. And I saw, met a little girl that was over here earlier. She started liking Skilly when she was, what'd you say, four? I like you. I like your parents. I honestly believe the parents who are good make their kids listen to Skillet. I'm not even joking. I'm talking about righteous parents. All around the world, people come up to us at concerts and they say, this next song we're gonna play, they say, this song is about my husband or my wife or my girlfriend or my boyfriend or my best friend. This song is about my kids. This song is about my parents. This song is about my teachers, whatever. I love that music can mean something different to every single person that hears a song. I love that. And that's why I think it's so cool. Probably tonight, just because we're at a Christian event doesn't mean that everybody here is a Christian. I assume, and I hope, actually, hope there's lots of different kinds of people here tonight that came to have a good time with us, no matter what you believe, or where you come from, or what color your skin is, or how much money you make, any of that kind of stuff. I love that music brings people together. And I always tell people, I don't care what the song means to you, as long as you sing it real, real loud. But I also gotta give a shout out for the person that we wrote this song for. I wrote this song for the person who never, ever lets me down. The person who gives me a reason to believe. The person who gave me a new life. The person that even when I was a sinner, died for me. That is my hero, Jesus Christ. Sing nice and loud if you want me. We'll be right back. Yeah. You people are loud. It's almost like you came to party. I love it, I love it, I love it. I think we can get some more music in before the new year here. Oh yeah, for sure. I would like to know, how many of you nerds out there love video games? How many of you guys got the new Spider-Man for Christmas? Not quite enough nerds. Me neither. Anyway, when I was growing up, I loved video games. Video games and rock and roll were two of my very favorite things in the whole world when I was young. And, but I'm here to tell you, now that I'm older, two of my favorite things in the world are new video games and old rock and roll. So, now that I am mature, that might sound really stupid, but I don't know if you have a best friend in your life, someone that whenever you feel really down that you love to be with or to talk to. But when I was growing up in high school, life could be hard. And I had a best friend. I would always go to his house on Friday and Saturday nights, and we would play video games and listen to rock and roll really loud. And that's what this song is about. So we're going to have a lot of fun. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to have to get you guys to sing nice and loud after me here. Because we got to lose our voices. Come on, let me see those things. After me.
Listen to the radio, bang on the radio.
For any particular reason, but I felt it pertinent this year, and I wanted to share it because the Christmas season, for a lot of people, is the very best season of the year. How many people feel like the holidays are the very best time of the year? And one of the things that sometimes we forget is that a lot of people suffer depression during holiday times, and part of it is that everybody else is having such a good time and you feel like that you must be the only one not feeling that way, and you can feel very alone. And I wanted to share this because I, by nature, am not a person who struggles with depression and things. I'm very up most of the time. The times in my life that I have been sad have been very dark and very angry, and they have been lonely. My mom died from cancer when I was 14 years old, which is something I talk about at our shows a lot. You may have heard before. One of the things we don't talk about a lot is the fact that my mom died in January, and when my mom was going through chemotherapy and the surgery and all this terrible stuff, she was in the hospital over Christmas, and we, as a 12-year-old kid, we postponed Christmas for a few weeks, which wasn't that big of a deal, except that every time I saw one of my friends, they say, "Hey, how was your Christmas?" And I would have to either lie, "Oh, it was good," or I would have to go, "Oh, that was all right. What'd you get for Christmas?" And then I didn't know what to say because we didn't get anything for Christmas because we were gonna wait until hopefully mom was better from cancer and this sort of thing. And they were just being good friends, but it became a really hard thing because I really didn't want to talk about it. And then you're stuck in a situation where you say, "Well, actually, my mom's sick," and they, "Oh, I'm really sorry." And then you feel really more alone than ever. And every year, this is decades ago, every year during the holiday time, for a day, 2 days, or 3 days, I will feel really, really sad, and I won't exactly know why. Every year catches me at a surprise. I go, "I remember feeling like this last year. What is this?" And it's this unbelievable aloneness that happens when you feel that you have lost something that you can never get back again. And once I realize what is happening, I pray to Jesus. And I remember when I was 15 years old, and my mom had died from cancer, and I was feeling alone, and I was depressed, and I wanted to hurt somebody. I remember that when I prayed to Jesus, that he became a faithful friend to me. He became a friend that would never leave me, and that would never forsake me. He became a best friend. And even better than a best friend, Jesus became a savior for me, and he gave me a brand new heart. He gave me a brand new start, a brand new life. And I want to share that because there might be people either watching all over the world, or there might be people here, and you feel like you're the only one that wasn't happy in the holidays, and it makes you feel more alone than you thought you could feel. I want you to know that Jesus knows your name, and he knows your pain, and he is listening to you tonight. This song is called Stars. You spoke a word and life began. Told oceans were starting to end. You stood in motion, time and space. But still you call, and you call to be my name. But still you call, and you call to be my name. If you can go past stars and planets, you can know my heart will say. Whenever I fall away, whenever I start to pray. So here I am, lifting up my heart to the one who rules the stars. Feel the deepest depths, darkest nights. Can't separate, can't keep me from the sight. I get so lost, forget my way. But still you love, and you don't forget my name. If you can know your stars in place, you can know my heart.
Starting the next respect you all by having conversation with the king. Dr. Weller here is going to lead us in prayer. Give him a round of applause.
Let's take a moment and just pray together. Let's calm our spirits and take a moment here. Just ask the Lord to bless this year. Father, we thank you so much for Jesus. We thank you for all that you've given us. We ask you, Father, that you will be the one to take our lives in this next year and use them in ways that we can never imagine before. Father, I pray for each young person here. I pray for those who made decisions over the last couple of days. Lord, I pray when they go back, those won't be temporary things, but will be eternal, Father. Father, I just pray right now for each of the youth leaders as they go back, Father, that you will renew them. And Father, I just pray as we go into this new year, Father, our lives will be used more than ever before. I pray, Father, that the gospel will ring on our lips. And Father, I just pray right now, in Jesus' name, we give this to you, all for your glory, Father. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people say, amen.
All right, guys, we got 30 seconds left. You feel it?
How you feeling in 2019? Feeling good? How many people feeling good back there? How many people over here feeling crazy in 2019? How many people at Liberty feel like a monster? I'm not afraid to sleeping as the shadows could be making history. Through the fire wall.